tweeted, "Black women will be protected when they listen and submit themselves to black men." Let me tell you what's wrong with this Christ-oganda, which Young Paco called it that. Just this week, three different black women harmed by three black men. Toyin, 19-year-old activist in Florida, was sexually assaulted and murdered, and it was a 49-year-old black man who was the assailant. Just yesterday, I've seen a black woman get smacked in the face with a skateboard at the hands of a black man. And then I saw black men throw a black woman in the dumpster while laughing and recording them. We gotta protect them from us. We're the harm. And in the Bible, we love to use the Bible when we're not even submitting to God. Just this week, three different black women harmed by three black men.
Why bars after police say she beat and shot at her boyfriend. Thanks for joining us. I'm Alex Coleman.
And I'm April Thompson. WREG's Quamitra Wilburn breaks down what led to that attack in Raleigh.
It was a quiet morning on Ridgemont Avenue in Raleigh. However, neighbors we spoke to who didn't want to go on camera say that peace was disturbed by multiple gunshots over the weekend. Memphis police say 21-year-old Anaya Buford is responsible, and she's now behind bars.
That's what she need to be.
Court documents say Buford's boyfriend was sitting in her car after she picked him up from work when he asked her to take him somewhere else. According to the victim, she told him no, and he took her key fob out of her center console. Memphis police say this reportedly upset Buford, and she started punching her boyfriend in the face. Police say when he got out of the car, she attacked him again and ran his face into the car, busting his lip. MPD says her boyfriend refused to fight back, and he tried to walk inside his house. From there, things allegedly escalated. Police say Buford called her father and said, quote, "I'm going to kill this B-word." Shortly after, MPD says Buford fired several shots at her boyfriend, leaving multiple bullet holes in his home. Her boyfriend was not hit.
According to Buford, told police that she believed her boyfriend was going to go get a gun, and that's why she fired shots at him. However, she also told police that he's never pointed a gun at her in the past, and he was unarmed that night.
I think she's a little on the touch side, and they need to take her to one of them funny hospitals.
Court documents say Buford was arrested and admitted to telling her father she was going to kill her boyfriend. She also told police when she refused to take her boyfriend to another location, he was the one that assaulted her. However, her boyfriend has not been charged. Buford is charged with second-degree attempted murder. Reporting in Raleigh, Quamitra Wilburn, WREG News Channel 3.
And Bruford is being held on a $100,000 bond. Her first court appearance is tomorrow morning.
What's up?
Spit it! You gonna spit it off?
What's up?
All right,
go to school.
Praises and the honor to Yahweh Bahashem, Yahawashah Bahashem, Recha Ha Kodash, and double honors to the elder apostles and the elders. Also of great millstone, Shalom. Also to you other Akiam, you so few sisters in sincerity. Also Shalom mainly to the elect, labor in sincerity. Anyway, I'm going to go in this video. It's kind of, as you've seen the three clips I put in. I'm going to just get right to it because it's, I only need a few scriptures. But I just want to bring out the point that, you know, the days of simping is over. I mean, at least when it comes to real men, you know, real Jake, you know, the days of that is over, right? So we see the situation. First of all, and I'll say this, you're really not a woman unless, let's read the online etymology. Now, we all know in the truth, know what woman means, which means goes to wife, right? But really the word woman means right here, female servant. That's what it means, female servant, right? So now we got to go on to see what is a servant, right? So that way you will understand you can't be a wife unless you are a servant to your husband, a personal or domestic attendant, you know, basically. That's what it says. To attend, to wait upon. That's what it says. So, I wanted to go into that, to go back to the topic at hand, when the Jake says that the woman need to be protected. First of all, we're not protected as men. You know, now you have to understand that we all came over here together. We all went through the hell together. Now the ability for us to be on top has been taken away. So how can a woman actually be a woman if you're put on the bottom? And you got Jakes like this that's helping to push us to the bottom, right? This is the sick part about it. You got Jakes like this that want to be on the bottom. He don't want to lead. He don't want to say, hey, you're women, you can't behave like that. All he's concerned about is protecting. Now, in order to protect them, you would need to make sure you as a man get yourself in order first. If that's the case, if that's your ideology, that's your way of thinking. And secondly, there's no way in this society I see a Jake getting into it with his woman, right? And I'm going to run up and protect her, not knowing who the hell started what. Now, it really shouldn't matter, because at the end of the day, she is supposed to be submissive to her husband. And if she's going back and forth brawling with him, well, she's not being a woman. So why the hell would I go protect her? And then there's many Jakes that get killed along the way with doing that. Let's go to Ciroc. 26, it looks like 23. A wicked woman is given as a portion to a wicked man. But a godly woman is given to him that feareth the Lord. So if you are a wicked woman, and what they're doing, trying to do, is lump all Jake in together. This situation in the third part of the video with the woman going in back and forth with the young man on the bus, and he so-called pushes and she sprays him with mace, and it's unbelievable what the comments say, right? They glorify the Queen of Heaven with this, man. Now, you're going to tell me this woman just didn't have that mace on hand, in her pocket? She's ready to use it, and she wants to use it. She provokes you to anger. Nobody says how it started, what happened. But yet, if this man comes back and shoots her and blows her away, you know what it's going to be said. I'll show some comments. This is the sick part about it. I don't know how I stumbled onto this stuff, but, you know, it's about staying focused and in edification. So, you know, we have to make sure, you know, we do that. Somebody says, this is what happens. Okay, this is a woman, you know, a bitter, you know, call them bitters. This is what happened when daddy doesn't stick around after he sticks it in. To all black men out here who are sexually active and don't use some birth control, she's not going to talk to the woman. This is the anger against men. It's always our fault, right? It is not okay to get a woman pregnant. Like the woman, you know, like we just walk up on a woman, push her down and get her pregnant, right? And avoid the responsibility of raising a child. Yeah, I can tell you many stories involved in even with, you know, myself, where there's women who don't raise children. You think just because you got a child and you're going to work and you're paying a couple of bills that you're raising a child? Well, what the hell are you doing? Why is these young men running around here acting like goddamn madmen? It ain't no excuse as a woman to raise a young man to the best of your ability. It ain't no damn excuse. But you know what they always do? They run back to victimization. Now it's the man's fault because the men are running wild. But then you look at the woman in the bus, how she was behaving and pushing on and instigating the situation. But nope, Nobody's going to say anything about her. This is why the scripture says the woman shall compass the man. Right? And then you have this other woman in the second video, right? This other woman who gets mad at her boyfriend for taking a car key. Then she blames she plays the victim all of a sudden and say, hey, it wasn't me. He threatened me first. Now you heard in the story, he didn't want to fight her. She beat him up, right? And everybody's enjoying this stuff with Jake. See, you Jakes, you don't know that you are a spectacle as us as Israelites, putting us on the bottom like that, making us look like a spectacle to the world. Now, I guarantee if this situation on the bus was a Edomite, you know, you wouldn't have had that. You know, nobody would have said that. They would have got on the black woman, right? But anyway, the man who got his ass, well, supposed to be got beat up. He took her face and hit it in the car or whatever. He was bloody. He ran in the house because he didn't want to fight. But she says he's going to get a gun, right? He's going to run in the house and get a gun, but yet he didn't ever want to fight. He could have clearly protected himself as a man against this woman, but he went to get a gun, so her excuse is she went to shoot up the place. Now, here's the sick part. She got $100,000 bail, right? She got $100,000 bail. You only have to pay 10% or 5% to get out, 10,000, maybe 5 G's. If you get a bail bond and do a 3%er, you got a couple of grand, you're out. She's going to get anger management, right? She's going to get some probation. She's going to go back to work, and she's going to live her life. Now, what would have happened if the situation was reversed and the man put his wife's face in the car door, bloodied her face, shot at her ass while she was going in the house, got an attempted murder charge? Guarantee you wouldn't have been no bail. But this is the sickness of this society and how they uphold Eve on high levels, right? It's always the black woman that claim the need to be protected. You don't hear no other woman running around here saying, hey, I need to be protected. Right. You should be being protected from the enemy. The enemy is the one that gave you the housing, the Section 8, the food, and the jobs and the careers, just so you can be over him. And you got to know that if you're a woman and you're not playing a submissive role, you're not protected, right? And you're not actually being a woman if you're on the top, you know? That's what it is. Let me get another comment real quick. It's about time women get held accountable for their domestic violence. And that's what I said before. No, they're not held accountable. They had to charge her ass, man. She shot up the damn house. She pulled a gun out and shot at the man while he's running in the house with $100,000 bail. No, she wasn't held accountable. Wow, all them dudes that are there and no one going to protect the girl, weak ASF, right? Nobody could protect the girl. She like she was protecting herself. She had that mace ready. We're talking about the bus one. Anyway, I got to get back to the scriptures. So Rock 23:14. A silent and loving woman is a gift from the Lord. And there is nothing so much worth as a mind well instructed. Right? So you're not technically a woman if you're not following this verse. And if you feel like, okay, I'm, you know, these men are all messed up and this or that, you always going for the so-called cute guy, the guy that looks good, the guy might look like maybe having a little money, something going for himself, instead of, hey, man, is this a decent person I got to deal with? And they always make it seem like it's the Jake. You know, it's always men that's messed up. It's a whole lot of women that screwed the hell up, man. This is crazy, man. But you know that Jake, in the beginning of the video, he'll do anything. You know? That Jake in the beginning of the video, he'll do, and it's a lot of guys like this. Somebody named Renee Rini Gonzalez or whatever, she's so beautiful. I would have knocked him out for her. Rup. And as long as you got Jakes like this, Eve will walk around with no fear, no sincerity, and do whatever the hell they want. It's easy to believe why she would go and shoot up someone's house. It's easy to believe why you would have mace on hand ready to spray somebody, starting shit just to spray somebody. But now if that young Jake, which he was wicked, no doubt, but if he comes back and bring a gun and blows her away, all those people, millions of views, and those people on the comment board, what are they going to say? See, they're no good. That's the sickness, man. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this, but it was definitely something that I wanted to check out. Let's go to Isaiah 13 and 12. I will make man more precious than fine gold. And this is what's happening. While all the super simps with the capes on, right, they're being all, you know, gung-ho for Eve, that's putting the spirit on Jake, you know. Jake is going to be shown as the real men. Let me see, starting with the elect. It's going to be shown. Things are going to get different. Let's put it that way. See, you can't have precious men without the simps. You know, that's part of the balance. That's part of the balance. It goes hand in hand. Anyway, I just wanted to touch on that. And I also say that in one of those comments that I first read, the woman on there, whatever, said if men would stand up and men would be fathers. Clearly this woman had a father. And she called her father, you know, because her father was probably in simp mode. You know, you got to protect your daughter. I understand that. But Jake goes over the top. If you're a man and, you know, and you have a daughter, she should be taught how to be a woman. She shouldn't be taught how to be better. You know, they're trying to raise him up high over a man. There's a position that she's supposed to play. But no, not these Jakes. These Jakes want their daughters to be better than their husbands. And that's exactly why she called her daddy, you know, and picked up that gun and went and shot at him. Premeditarily, because she did call daddy first. And you know what daddy was saying. Any man put his hands on you, you get him, right? But nobody says, you know that's a man, you shouldn't put your hands on him. Nobody says that shit. I remember being young. I had family. I'm not going to say who it is, but got into it with a woman who jabbed him with a pencil. Damn near put his eye out. Well, he hit her, and she got hurt. But do you know what the daddy came and said? In my day, we never put our hands on a woman. But nobody went to this young lady and said, you don't stab men or anybody in the face or damn near their eyes and blind them, you know? You don't do things like that. But this is why Eve does that. There's no fear. She does whatever Eve wants to do. And this is the sick part of society, man. And this is all formulated by the Queen of Heaven. This is Babylon, man. Jeremiah 44 all day. That's all I have on that. Shalom.